前有座山，山里头有座庙，庙里有个老和尚讲故事。他讲的是什么呢？功夫是个啥？传说有绝学，深山藏秘籍，觅得于神兵，逍遥闯江湖，仗义行天下。
The Shaolin Temple is sacred for both Buddhism and Kung Fu. It's been known and revered for its Kung Fu for centuries. This wall separates two worlds. These three generations of monks hold different dreams.The Shaolin Temple has experienced ups and downs in its long history. What unique and high-level skills do today's monks possess? The Shaolin Temple monks now demonstrate their legendary Kung Fu skills to the world. Cha Yanao gets up at 5 a.m. every morning and begins his day working to improve himself. Now in his 50s, he has mastered many of the high-level Kung Fu skills taught in Shaolin Temple.
我们现在来到的呢，是禅宗和武术的发源地少林寺的山门前。在这里，您看到了清代的山。
This ancient temple here is home to people with hidden talents. For more than 1,500 years.The Kung Fu of the Shaolin Temple has been legendary in China. The Shaolin Temple now attracts over 3 million visitors a year, many hoping to hone their Kung Fu skills. Unfortunately, the legendary monks of old are nowhere to be seen.The real Shaolin Temple only emerges when all leave and the gate is closed.Yi Jin Jing is an excellent way of strengthening muscle and bone that has been passed down for thousands of years. It is Sha Yan Ao's task to teach it to the young monks.
易筋经确切地说是少林寺高深的内功修炼法。少林寺练什么武功，达不到顶峰的时候，通过练习这易筋经，他的功法进展得很快，啊，突飞猛进。易筋经啊。流传到社会中间也有很多版本，少林寺它有少林寺的练法，内功心法很重要， 他是要考师傅的口传神授，他的一口气就是说从涌泉穴一下能提上这个，从这个督脉一下能达到这督脉走完。看着是很简单，其实简单易学，但是练的时候是难练的。什么人都练，通过了很长时间，甚至是十年二十年，这种武术基础达到一定时候了，那么就是把这易筋经慢慢的一点一点的传给你。
Practicing Yi Jin Jing requires some prior training. Xia Yan Ao selects six monks skilled at boxing and stick exercise to teach them.
易筋经它主要是从内功上能帮助，通过练内功，打了拳头有浑圆之力，有穿透力。
Yi Jin Jing is designed to strengthen bones and muscles. It helps the person overcome physical and mental restrictions. Xia Yan Ao guides these six monks as they begin their basic training. This is not the only great Kung Fu skill found at the Shaolin Temple. The practitioner must make the muscles and bones strong enough to endure the heaviest blows.
I think that the people who can't do it, you can do it. That's the answer.不出手就能把对方给折服，这才是真正的高手。
45-year-old Xia Yan Wu has been practicing the Golden Bell Shield and the Iron Shirt technique for over a decade. He is one of the few people who still practice it.
我有一个梦想，要把少林的一个绝技重现人间。铁布衫是少林武学里面的绝学，真正的金钟罩铁布衫是没有罩门的，就是任何身体的要害部位都能承受的重击。
Xia Yan Wu has been receiving secret training while living for 10 years in Hui Shan Temple on Mount Song. Today, another vital part of his body will face an extreme challenge.
Yan Hu 这部位都是环状软骨嘛，一打都碎了。这个要比胳膊开个棍儿、腿上开个棍儿难度大多了。
The monks have to endure heavier and heavier blows to build up their endurance. In Xia Yan Wu's Kung Fu world, nothing is impossible.
Any 一个部位要想你把它强大下来，要有训练的阀门。 这就是靠自己去悟。
When he gets tired during practice, Xiaoyan Wu goes to a back room to meditate and regain his inner strength.
Yang Wu 的人最难的就是能把心静下来，修禅才能让人有静心，有悟心。
The throat is an especially vulnerable part of the body, requiring Xiaoyan Wu to do some special and even torturous training.
This technique is in the Wushu, called Gui Qi. If I let the rope fall, I can, right?闭住气，20分钟没问题。内功到顶峰的时候，才能达到这种境界。
Xiaoyan Wu is also engaged in another secret training exercise that he never shows to others.After practicing in secret for 300 days, Xiaoyan Wu finally succeeds. He's now ready for the challenge of 14 blows to his throat.
I want to let the world know.少林寺还有真功夫的存在，还有真正武术绝学的存在。
The Shaolin Temple has been gathering natural medicinal herbs for many centuries to treat injuries. This is also something kept secret from the outside world.
到少林寺药局原初到现在正好是800年的制药的传统呢，我们叫丹散膏丸，大概有2000多个药方。那么这些药方就是历代的禅师、历代的武僧，啊，通过他的经验积累下来。
Xia Yanlin hopes that the temple's herbal remedies can become popular outside the temple, but cultivating and harvesting the herbs is hard work.
8点的时候上山，一是路远，二是路不好走。到山上的时候大概就10点。
Shaolin Temple has a plot of land on Mount Song, where monks cultivate herbs that only grow here. Sha Yanbai works on the plot all summer.
院门这个地方就旱，然后今年还特别旱，确实，这是个大问题，好多药材它活不了啊。你说不能老是颠个桶啊，爬1000多米爬到山上，然后一个浇水啊，太大了浇不坏了，所以呢，今年收成不好也没办法。
Xia Yanlin must harvest the herbs at just the right time to ensure maximum potency.
一年有24节气，一天有12个时辰，因为它这个自然生态它有个规律，什么时候生什么，什么时候长什么，我们要取它最有效的时候，最有效的部位，还有采摘时间也很讲究啊，否则这个时间点过了以后，这个药性就没有。
黄连甘草。The end of the traditional Chinese calendar is the busiest time.When they prepare an ancient medicinal plaster.
金芥麦冬、石膏、青皮各四两，土硝、幽荆仁、青土三钱，白方五钱。
有少林寺的膏药，它有大方跟小方，小方的话一般七八种就可以了，一般我们用的是大方那个，大概有50多个，可以追风的，可以镇痛的，可以除湿的，用的范围就比较广一点。
The key to the effectiveness of these preparations is in the timing, where the herbs are grown and how they are prepared.
冬至时候要开始进补，这个时候能量场都在收了，这个时候去做。
那下面还有剩多少药？剩不下了。别，一个人，别，全部一个人。
The night is the longest at the winter solstice.The monks begin preparing the materials at 9 a.m.
熬膏药是有讲究的，特别是个风很要紧，因为风的话呢，对火候不好掌握。要下单的时候，那鸡全部不能听得到声音的，还有个厂不能去破它。
The fire's sudden flare-up reduces the herbs to ashes. Even the slightest error can lead to failure. Failure can occur in the blink of an eye.
可惜的这些鱼窝，要是活起来的，你看我又知道这一锅完了，只有心情很糟糕。
All their efforts last year were in vain. They have to start all over again the next year. The last month of the Chinese calendar has arrived, and they again begin to make the plaster. In accordance with Shaolin temple tradition, the monks first pray to the Buddha of medicine.
We are praying for God, not praying for ourselves, praying for our own heart.我们要做好准备了，我们要开始熬药了，这是精神要全身人关注了。你的发愿跟不发愿做一样事是不一样的。
They begin preparing the herbs, following the required protocol. 8 hours later, the plaster finally takes shape.
熬膏药就在一个“熬”字，就跟练功夫一样，你要熬啊，熬的时间到了就成了。
Spring has arrived.After he puts them through strict basic training, Xia Yanao begins to teach Yi Jin Jing to the 6 monks he selected.
它能疏通你自己的经络，能增加你的丹田之气。
来，走，双手交叉胸前，腰过肩，然后身下沉，下沉，脚尖着地，脚跟离地，过肩。身形坚定，咬牙，下腰开，慢慢的。
The monks need to learn from a tutor to truly master these skills. They also need to work hard and show some insight. Shaoyan Ao is not satisfied with the progress of these young monks.
但是离我们以前练功的刻苦不一样，那刻苦那是仇富好的去刻苦。现在的年轻的时候，人物的练啥都够了就行了。比方说低架子，他不想低了，就高一点，高一点升劲儿。可能时代不一样了。Times
have changed, and the Shaolin Temple is keeping up with the changing times. Xia Yanbo was born in the 1980s. The things he learned are totally different from those of Xia Yan Ao. He uses different methods to train his body.
Left hand first, relaxing. So be a one-liner.
Xia Yanbo also teaches Kung Fu to foreigners, for which he studied English. Over 2,000 foreigners come to Shaolin Temple each year to learn Kung Fu.
So we practice like slowly, but the body is never stop here, no.
The ultimate skills of the Shaolin Temple are not confined to within the temple walls. The young monks are staying in touch with the outside world through the internet. A Belgian director has invited Xia Yanbo to perform in a dance performance with Kung Fu elements. He keeps up his usual training as he prepares for his performance abroad. He's rolling with the changes in this multifaceted world and realizing his dream on an even bigger stage. Shaolin Kitty Kung Fu is another ultimate skill. Sha Xiao Song has spent 4 quick years in the Shaolin Temple, but he has never had to really work hard at Kung Fu. The temple is just like an amusement park for him. Xia Xiao Song also had to learn all the rules of the temple. At 5 a.m., he's still sleepy, but he has to get up and attend class with the others.
Morning. 说多少次了，这胳膊是抻直的，这个拳能打直不能？能吗？错的，拳打直人家这样的胳膊给你擒拿了，明白没有？拳打出去，打出去，叭再收回来。
大兄弟，走。
还伸直，还伸直，直好。这个拳直的还是弯的？坐好。哭是不可能解决问题的。这个拳在上边了啊，你要人家打到你脑袋了，架打，这样我就打不到，用点劲儿，用劲。练拳连自己保护都保护不了自己，练拳干嘛？眼神狠一点，眼神聚集在一起。起。嗯，记住了啊，再忘记的话你还是要挨揍的啊。歇一会儿吧。
Though Sha Sao Song has become familiar with these routines, it will require decades of practice and reflection before he will be fully competent. There are no shortcuts. Practicing Kung Fu does not occupy all his time. He also has some recreational activities.Sha Sao Song has to endure what all the other disciples have endured, but he will also experience things they haven't. Outside the temple is a very different world. It's still foreign to Sha Sao Song, but in the future he will learn about this new and colorful world. Sha Sao Song doesn't really know exactly what ultimate skills are, but to outsiders, he's already mastered them.
Film, you just try to get
that's okay. No.
Focus.
Yeah, yeah,
I told them already.
Told them. Thanks.
我是一名少林弟子，我叫释延姿。1984年，我来到嵩山少林寺学习功夫。在1998年，我师父派我去伦敦创建英国少林文化中心。我这一次回中国是来参加1月3号的世界王者。搏击争霸赛。
46-year-old Sha Yan Zha has been teaching Shaolin Kung Fu in London for 17 years. Strength is greatly prized in the West, so he always tries to show the power of Shaolin Kung Fu in combat. Kung Fu.Is a symbol of Chinese culture, as well as the martial art of Shaolin Temple. In this championship, Sha Yan Zha embodies the glory and dreams of both Shaolin Temple and Kung Fu.
我作为一个少林的弟子，我还有很多的师兄弟，还有很多的学生，非常关注这个事情，说你赢了都好，你一旦输了，那么少林寺就输了。
Shaolin Kung Fu, with its powerful moves, was created for combat. But times have changed, the rules have changed.And so has the nature of Kung Fu. Can it still be useful in combat?
在古代，功夫是用在战争上面的。那也是为了实战的，哎，只不过那个时候实战，它不是在拳台上面，它是生死搏斗，它一出手就要见生死，不是光见输赢的。如果武术不能用来搏击，我觉得就不应该称为武术了，我们可以称为健身运动。
After returning to Shaolin Temple, Xia Yanzi refuses to see visitors and begins to practice in private.
我那个年代没有赶上这么多的赛事，现在这个机会有了，赛事放开了。我虽然四十多了，我不甘心，不管大家怎么看我，这是我的决心，这是我的心愿。
Because of Xia Yanzi's age, it's hard to predict how he will do. Some other disciples decide to put his skill to the test before the contest. He will only be able to compete if he defeats them.
Shaolin的名声不是虚名啊，先祖们他们用他们的命换来了教训，然后呢传给我们说什么招管用，什么招不管用，那怎么就是擂台？你要经常去跟别人去交锋，你要全身心的超越胜负，超越生死，超越名利的，去用你的行动去告诉大家。
There was only 1 month to go before the championship meet. Xia Yanzi is in Beijing for kickboxing training. He's facing a particular challenge.
You're young的时候是靠初生牛犊不怕虎，我跟你拼了！你这个年龄的时候不是靠拼的，你要靠。
His strong opponents, the strange rules, and the high expectations of Kung Fu fans and practitioners put a great deal of pressure on Xia Yanzi. This championship is very important for him.
中国有一句古话是这样说的：“姜还是老的辣。”
顶级精英，英雄传说2023世界国际王者争霸赛的比赛现场，非常高兴，我们今天邀请到了。泰国的贝康南，法国的尼古拉斯，加拿大的马库斯，加拿大的马库斯，这也是应该说在今天的所有国外选手当中实力最为强劲的一位。
对，他是被称为在80公斤级泰拳。
我给他开，我给他。
Chinese kickboxers have already lost several matches before Xia Yanzi enters the arena, which increases the pressure on him.
In 1988, he is the world champion of three fights. This year, he is 46 years old. He has the ability to stand on the stage and face the younger than he is 8 years old.泰国老将了，有请赤炎姿师傅。
Xia Yanzi is not used to gloves and soon breaks a finger. He can no longer punch with full force, and his predicament is dire. The hands should be used for distraction.So you can attack with the legs. Xia Yanzi adjusts his strategy in the second round, using his legs more. He quickly gains the advantage over his opponent, and things begin to look better.
的功夫是由苦而来的，你要吃得了常人吃不了的苦，要几十年如一日坚持不懈，
这就是中国的功夫。
It's now winter and it's snowing. Xia Yanao begins to teach the six monks an even more important kung fu skill.
十月初，大漠族是诞辰纪念日，开始七七。一般我们少林寺是打七个七，七七49天。我们七七之前都要去佛祖搞这个生死架。
Autumn and winter are the best times for meditation, because people tend to be more calm and collected then.
一天做12支香。这个每日香有40分钟，有一个半小时的。
Not all monks can meditate for 49 days because they find it difficult to sit calmly for so long.
做禅的有做禅的规矩，不前倾不后仰，身正，不要打瞌睡，你做不好了就要挨板儿。
Xia Yanlin is making a special kind of herbal tea for the monks who are meditating. The tea contains 30-some herbs and is good for calming the nerves and resisting the cold. They meditate to get rid of improper thoughts and purify their minds. The ultimate skills of the Shaolin Temple require unity of body and mind. A practitioner must stay focused to achieve the highest level of Kung Fu. When their bodies move, their hearts remain calm. The monks here spend their whole life practicing Kung Fu. Days can go very quickly. But for these monks, the days are long and arduous. When they finally leave the room, they look totally different. The Thousand Buddha Hall, the most holy place in the Shaolin Temple, is now open to them.
今天晚上我们练习易筋经的终极练法。终极练法最重要就在呼吸，在以前的呼吸基础上再进一步。啊，吸的时候啊，一定要提裆夹肛。啊，顺着气向督脉慢慢上。上到命门向前推，呼气的时候向丹田沉，所以这个是丹田功啊。丹田从小腹部，从丹田要转，气会转，一走气不要停留，不要憋气，憋气就如中火功。大家一定要体会。不慌不忙，否则的话，气停着不动，很长时间。
Generations of high-level monks have practiced kung fu in the Thousand Buddha Hall. The 48 footprints in the hall show the power of Shaolin kung fu. They also show the magic power of time.
What?
没有成那一说，只有坚持才是没有边缘的。
After returning to the Shaolin Temple, Che Yanzi sets up a new training ground on the mountainside, where he will teach the ultimate skills to young monks based on his experience. Cha Yen Wu is practicing the skill of Iron Crotch, the highest level of Golden Bell Shield in Iron Shirt technique. After Cao Song trained here for 5 years, his father came to take him home. Now he often acts. His childhood will no longer be the same. In early 2015, the musical Dragon Dance features Xia Yanbo demonstrating Shaolin Kung Fu for 12 minutes. Now that he has succeeded in the mission his tutor gave him, Xia Yanao comes to pay his respects to his predecessors. It takes time to master the ultimate skills, because miracles don't happen overnight. Mastering the ultimate skills requires insight and means making the impossible possible. There are many legends concerning the secrets of Kung Fu. What are the secrets of Kung Fu? Are these secrets legendary, or do they really exist? We'll explore the secrets that have been buried for a century and look at their future. Join us for part two of the Kung Fu Shaolin.
Yeah.